All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to episode 13 of our Sable playthrough. We're on our gliding, and we're about to go and try and get over to that ship over there. So, I guess it really just starts with a jump. I'm just gonna jump over here. Split toe shoe makes missteps at great heights less likely. Grips on the soles make exploration easier on foot. Yeah, let's put on some new wear. So let's go with this. We're gonna keep the mask. But, I just like this one. Okay, sweet. Some different pants to wear. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Okay, now we're gonna jump over there. Well, hope for the best. Here goes nothing! Here now. Looks like just like a giant birdhouse. Catch our breath before we venture forwards. Let's see here. way should we head up first? Head up this way. Why, hello! Boatmaker Jake. Hey there, how can I help you today? What is this place? It's an ancient Hecarian ruin. We found it years ago and have been trying to get it back to life since. Cool, right? After we got the bird towers up and running, I spent a long time figuring out how to farm and engineer those big bones you see across the shales. That's how we navigate the rocks, ferry ourselves around. If you have a bike, I've got some interesting parts to sell. If you see Umi around, say hello. It's nice to see someone else up there. I'd like to trade with you. Brilliant. Look at my wares. The boat. Only costs $4.50 to buy. We're gonna hold off. But I'll definitely come back up. We'll buy these boat parts eventually. I'm not going to comment that I climbed through that. We're just going to be excited we found a chum egg. Traveled a long way. Not often we get travelers. You live up here? Only for parts of the year. The winds get rough and it becomes hard to stay. Better get on the sands and sail up what we can in the hard months. I do love it up here with the winds are steady. Nothing quite like riding a boat through towers of rock. The bird crap is the only downside. The profitable one, at least. Why are you out here? I'm just harvesting some bird excrement we get from these towers. See you around. Interesting. Cool beans. Let's see, if I came from that way. Whales over there. That's all we have left to do is put a marker out there and travel. Do want to see if I can scare that away, and I do gotta visit the worm. But let's just go out this way. haven't been out this way before. And she appeared. It's time we go explore something I've never seen before. It's about to be night, too. Literally riding off into the sunset. I feel like is that already another cartographer balloon? Yeah, it is. Let's give that a mark. Oh my god. That's beautiful. Let's go explore what this is. Equally beautiful. Very pretty. Oh, living in the new area is a little chunky. Yeah, okay. So it's just floating, dog. I don't know how on earth I'm gonna get up there. Doesn't look like it's connected to any. Yeah, ha ha. Carab's hold. There's a worm up there. Another worm. This is just filled with worms, dude. Nuts. Giant beetles.
Thank you.
Slicer Beetle poo. Okay. You know what? Let's collect it. People like poo. I'm sure this will sell for something. Let's get out of here. We've collected enough poop. The eye thing scares me. I was about to be like, can I not climb out of here? Am I stuck harvesting beetle poop for the rest of my gliding? Am I destined to be a poop collector? Probably not. Can I climb to the top of this? It feels like way too high up. Definitely something up there. Let's see if there's a way to get up there. Come on, baby. Come on, Sable. Hold on. I know that I can do this. Doesn't want me to climb up there. Well, maybe we want them. Northwest of Seven Sister Station. So this way. Cool. to the cartographer. Absolutely crazy. Whoa, don't. Whoa, Sable, chill out. Came back full circle. A short path. My dog ever greets me slowly, like they're not sure if I'm really there or not. What? Oh, right. Hello. Come a long way, haven't you, glider? My voice wavers a bit. Welcome to the Black Sea. Akoa! I ask if they're alright. Better than alright. I'm brilliant. What should I see nearby? They respond like I should already know what they're about to say. Of course, you should find shelter at Seven Sisters Station. Not sure if you'll find any sisters, though, let alone seven of them. They look up thoughtfully. Ooh, Glowworm Cave is a magical place. You must take some time for it now that you're here. Weird as anything, you'll love it. And then there's something really special about the Crystal Plateau. Though I wasn't able to get my balloon out, that doesn't mix well with lighting, you see. Well, can I buy a map? Certainly. Have a look. I'll buy this, just this. Ring. This is going to be the last ring we need. I think at least. Map. I believe that's where I need to go. Let's ping that. Ping that. Ping that. Head to the purple one first, though. Epic. Quite a nasty storm cloud over there. You guys are big. A lot of big guys. A Cohen merchant Hyman. Tell me about this camp. They don't seem interested in answering my questions. The silence is intense and comfortable. I came here years ago with the plateau. It calls to be studied. Lightning-infused crystals that grow out of the sides of floating rocks in the Crystal Plateau. Extremely risky to harvest. The power inside each crystal is extremely powerful and volatile. Cracking one can be dangerous. I'll buy it. Okay, it's three. I'll just take one. I sell this guy. Okay. What about you? First sight, the crystal farmers are so striking that I nearly gasp, but their height is immense and they move with such calm that I cannot help but ascribe some higher knowledge to them, or see some wisdom of age in the curves of their backs. Then I remind myself my reading is informed by the markers I see among my own people, the short lands of a culture, and these farmers are in no way beholden to my interpretation. I wonder what they make of me. Greetings, crystal farmer. Greetings, glider. I am Tohta. You are? I expect his voice to emerge as a rasp, but instead spills like silk from behind his crystalline mask. There is a purity in the sound of him. Every word reaches me as cleanly as a whisper in the ear. I speak slightly louder than normal to ensure that I'm heard up there. Tell him my name is Sable. How may I help you, Sable? I have not met a... I tell Tohta that he's the first crystal farmer I've ever met. And to add that I hope it isn't rude of me to mention. He shifts his weight and the crystals on his back move lazily around him. Oh, we must look very odd to you. Oh, certainly not. I protest, but it only makes Tohta chuckle. I ask if I look odd to him. You don't, which is particularly because I've met others like you, but also because we are the different ones. I offer that we are both different, and somehow I swear he smiles. I am not sure that's something we decide. Anything else I can do for you? What is this place? Tohta raises one of his walking sticks up and points it skyward to gesture to the Crystal Plateau, leaning in at an angle that speaks to some impressive strength. We built it. It was made to draw lightning storms away from the rest of Hakoa and concentrate them on that peak. As it happened, a side effect of that concentration was the formation of lightning crystals charged with electricity. It makes a circle in the air. Isn't it a wonder? We turned a bane into a boon, and a boon into a culture. All the chemicals and coincidences that conspired to create the crystal farmers. I nod in agreement, and suddenly this place I thought a factory feels more like a place of worship. Anything else I can do for you? Where are those big robots? Those are the reason my shoulders are complaining and my knees are grinding the dust. They used to harvest our lightning crystals, but now we must do it ourselves, and it's not easy work. That is what happened. They stopped, all at once. One day after a storm that seemed otherwise entirely normal, they all simply stopped. Some fell over, others stayed up, but none of them ever moved again. In sympathy, I say that must have felt a terrible omen. He shakes his head, and it's the quickest I've seen him move. Oh, nothing like that, no. There is some explanation in the mechanics or the chemistry, even if we don't know it, and in that, at least, we take great comfort. I nod, and I think in some way I understand them better. Anything else I can do for you? Goodbye. Can I talk to any of these other fellows? Hello? Hello? Let's go explore. You know what? If we're gonna explore, let's do it in a proper outfit that we just received. Boom. Boom. Honestly, the scrapper mask feels fitting. Whoa. Can't return way too fast. Those robots are massive.
Thank you.
on Sable. You don't mind me climbing on you, sir. What was that? Crystal Plateau. It's like raining crystals in here. Sound is terrifying. Am I inside the helm? I fell out of his foot. Okay. I'm not sure if there is anything I can do here. Nothing of value to me, up here at least. So I want to get back on this case. That was worth the travel. Certainly. So it looks like they form and then I can collect like the little ones on the sides, but I guess it's just a harvesting ground for these crystals. Well, all right. Let's check out the map. So this is the Crystal Plateau. Firm. Ooh, that's a ship. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you have enjoyed today's episode, please do not forget to like the video, subscribe if you're new here, comment down below what you enjoyed. In the next one, we will see what's inside this boat. Alright, guys. See you later. Bye.